Everybody, welcome to Caketastic Cakes. It's Jen, and I'm going to show you today how to make CatRat from Gabby's Dollhouse out of gum paste. And if you see me using any tools or supplies that you can use, if you check the link in the description below, it should be able to help you out. Okay, to begin with our CatRat, I'm going to start with his head. And just like most of the cats on Gabby's Dollhouse, he has an enormous head. So I'm starting with some light blue gum paste, and I have started kind of with a circle, but now I've pinched at the bottom, kind of flared out at the bottom, and sloped a little bit inward. You see how it's shaped there? I don't know what it would be shaped like, but you can see the two little flares out to the sides at the bottom and how it tapers up toward the top. That's basically the overall shape that we're going to keep working with this guy. I'm making his eyes now, his eye sockets. I'm using the small part of my ball tool there to make a line across and then make a swoop down below it. So we're doing like a half a circle for his eyes because he always has kind of that, I don't know, that shady look going on about him that you don't necessarily trust 100%. I'm going to add his stripes now. I took some purple gum paste, rolled it really, 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 really thin, and as you see, I made a diamond for the top of his head. So the part that you see when you look at the front of him is just going to be the triangle that comes down, but it does actually turn into a diamond and then go into the back of his head. For the sides of his face, for the stripes that come around the sides by his cheeks, I made two, I don't even know what these shapes would be, long shapes that are pointed on each end and fatter in the center. And I am just very gently and carefully wrapping it around his head and just folding it over in the back. I don't watch the show. My kids are too big, so I don't actually know what he looks like from behind on his head. So, if this is wrong, just add whatever spots or stripes or whatever he's got going on appropriately, and then yours will be better than mine. See? No problems. I'm doing his ears now. I'm using the same dark purple gum paste. I cut two very tall triangles because his ears are very thin and tall. They're not quite as round or wide as some of the other cats we've done before. And I've hollowed out the center there using my veining tool to make a couple little triangles. You see what I'm doing right there? Just press down in the center, and then I'm going to take some hot pink. There's my nephew. I'm babysitting today, so he ended up in my footage a little bit that I couldn't quite, edit around him. So we'll say hi to my nephew. Hi, nephew. Okay, so I've got the pink gum paste that I am putting into the center of each ear. I just rolled it into kind of like a little point and just placed it in with a little bit of water, press it into shape, trim off any extra that you need to, and then when you place the ears, you're going to add a little bit of water, stick them on either side of the stripe on top of his head, and make sure they're kind of pretty high on top of his head. They don't come out to the sides too much either, so just be careful of placement. All right, now that I've got that going on, I put a piece of white gum paste into the eye socket that I made. And I'm using the big ball and the small ball in my tool there just to smooth it out, round it out, kind of press it in, and make sure you keep that nice flat line across that top. Make sure you keep your half circle shape going. Now I'm going to add the white patch that's on his face. I've seen different pictures of him. Sometimes it looks white to me, other times it looks very, very, very light blue. So, act accordingly, use whatever color you think is best. But I started with a circle. And I'm using a smaller circle to cut two little nips out of each side of the circle. So, and then I cut the top off with my X-Acto knife there, basically replicating the shape of his head again. And that way it will fit between his eyes and go down and around his mouth, kind of like his little fuzzy muzzle. And that little pink bean you see me working with there, that really little small piece of pink, I'm cutting it into a very loose triangle. That's going to become his nose, as you see, because I just put it on his face for his nose. And now I'm going to start filling in his eyes. I took black, rolled it out really thin. This is all gum paste still. Cut it in half, so I've got two little half circles, and I'm just putting them inside of the white of his eye sockets. There is white that shows all around the black, so it's not filling in his eye all the way, so be careful of that because he does have a lot of black showing, or I'm sorry, excuse me, white showing around his eye. I'm going to add a little ball of white to each eye for a little highlight. I'm just putting a little bit of water on, then using my paintbrush handle actually to put it into place. And now I'm adding a dark blue, kind of just like a little bean. It's skinny on each end, and I'm just following the bottom curve of his eye a little bit and just kind of pressing it in because his eyes do have color, but they're so dark, it really doesn't show very well. This is black gum paste. I rolled it really long and thin just between my fingers, between my hands, and to make his eyebrows. And when you put them on, make sure you cut the eyebrows so that it's you have that long, skinny, tapered end, and then it cuts off blunt in the center, or toward the front, the other end of the eyebrow. Because his eyebrows are very, very sculpted. They're very flat and then thick, and then they go very long and thin. So just be careful of that. And I have one going arched and one a little cocked because he's kind of got attitude. All right, this blue piece you see me working on here, I just put it on a lollipop stick, is going to be his body. He has, again, a tiny body compared to his head, so make sure you give him a tiny body compared to his head, which might also mean you'd have to give the head time to set and the body time to set before you join them together. So, you know, keep that in mind. Anything really big you put on top of anything small could crush it. So make sure you have plenty of time for everything to dry to support that kind of weight. I added, as you saw there, as I talked through it, a little white belly patch. It was just white gum paste that I had shaped like a big old Tic Tac that I flattened out and rolled long, stuck in place. These are pieces of blue gum paste, the same as his body, that's going to become his legs. So I'm going to make his little white paws first. I just took a ball of white gum paste, used my knife blade to make two indentations so he has three toes. Use a little bit of water to connect it to the bottom of the leg. And the other end of the leg, you see, I cut it off at an angle. So now it's going to kind of lay into the body. It's going to press up against it, but it's going to taper and gradually just go into the body. So once again, there's the two toes. Going to connect it to the foot, or excuse me, that is a foot. Going to connect it to the leg. I cut the wedge off at an angle where the thigh is, so now it'll just kind of blend into the body better where they're connected. And it all comes together like so. Yes, there we go. Just like that. So easy. Actually, he's really not bad to make. He really isn't. There's not a lot going on with him. I'm going to make his arms next, exactly the same thing. I'm going to roll out a piece of gum paste really long and kind of thin. Cut it off at each end, taper the one end, as you saw, that's going to go up against the body, or into the shoulder right there. And I'm going to have his arms and his paws coming into the front of his body, because he kind of sits like Gollum, honestly, like a little creepy old hunched over creature, with his little paws rubbing together sinisterly, you know, just that kind of an approach. So that's what I'm trying to emulate here. So again, the other side's the same thing. I tapered the shoulder, attached it, bent it at the elbows, and I'm making two little white balls with, again, the two pressure lines in order to make three toes and put his little paws together like he does. He's just kind of shady little character. This long piece, just like the arms and legs, is going to be his tail. Again, cut it at an angle so it'll go up against his bottom nice and smooth without any issues. I wanted his tail to show because he really, again, doesn't have a lot going on. He has a few stripes you see on his head, and then really it's just his tail. I'm going to add a couple stripes to his back because at one point I did see him turn around and he had some back stripes, so there you go there. But this long, skinny piece of purple is going to be all about the tail. So I rolled it, again, very thin as I could get it, really. I'm going to lay it over the tail. I put a little brush of water over the tail first to make it stick. And then I'm going to trim off any extra. And see, I learned after that first stripe that I should cut on the outside where it's easier to manipulate. So that's what I'm doing. I'm just going to keep laying some stripes over his tail, wrap it around, tuck it under, trim off the extra, you know, make sure it's all nice and tucked. And there's his stripy tail. And for the end of his tail, he has like a purple cap on it. So I just made a purple circle and just wrapped it over the edge. Just capped the end of his tail just like that. And there you go. See, his body's there. One last little thing I'm going to do. I'm going to add his mouth. I'm using a food coloring marker to very carefully draw his thin, long smile that he has. Stick it onto his lollipop stick there very carefully. There you go. CatRat. Nice and easy, right? He is actually pretty simple. All right, so I do hope you found this video helpful. Please like and subscribe because it really does help me out. I've got a lot of other videos out there, a lot of other Gabby's Dollhouse cats, so check those out too. And as always, thank you very much for watching Caketastic Cakes.